Alright, y'all. This is Rps Game live in the flesh. I'm making, I don't know what I'm fucking doing, but we gotta get this shit out here. All these casinos, they have like 50k budgets. They be throwing that shit out there like no tomorrow. But we gotta do this organically. We gotta, you know, do these TikToks and bullshit like that just to get this shit out here. I'm trusting you guys to spread the word about the skill-based casino. You know, it's better than a fucking trying to guess the fucking dice faces. You know, you got no control over that. Anyway, whatever, let's just get straight into this, motherfuckers. Let's just get straight into this. Alright. So, what do we have here? $50 in the account. I'm trying to do this like you guys, you know, come to the site. Brand new, you're not going to deposit 5k in there straight away. You're going to test the waters. Maybe $10. We'll do the $10 video later. But we'll try and spin this $50 for now, okay? So I'm going to teach you how to play this motherfucker. So each room has its own strategy. You've got to try and guess that strategy. You know, it could be random or it could be an AI. If it's random, then you use probabilities to count it. If it's AI, you try and guess the pattern. Don't try and do the wrong way around. Alright. So, let's just assume this motherfucker is random. This host created this room with a random algorithm. Like, you get this opportunity. You get this these choices to choose which one you want. Right? Anyway. The way to do this is you try and see the past five or whatever ain't been played. So that, see, that would have been an opportunity there, because it hadn't played P for a while, so it chose P. So now we missed that opportunity, but it hasn't played Rock for a minute. So we're gonna go for Rock next. What? So count a Rock, paper. Increase the stakes. Don't increase them too high and get too confident, because that shit fails more time. We're just trying to play cool, but now we're going a little bit too in, so that's where the thing starts. We've got to face this now to reel it back, alright? So, fuck it, let's just go 20 on the rock. 20 on the rocks. Same thing, if it plays the same streak over and over again, like paper, then it's either going to play rock or scissors. And counter rock or scissors, you got to choose rock. Do we go for rock or do we go for paper? Let's just play it risky for now and go paper. Okay, so it's played literally paper for a minute. So we're gonna go fat out with a rock. We can't lose. We can't lose, man. It's not gonna play paper again. Okay, so we got that shit. We got that shit. We're on 47, 74 now. You feel? We use that probability shit all over. All right. So we're gonna restart that shit. Although it hasn't played rock for a minute. So if it plays rock now, I'm pissed. Okay, so it hasn't played rock for a minute. Which means we can increase these stakes like a motherfucker. Not too high, not too high. To paper. And if we get this, then we get this. Okay, we should have increased the stakes a little bit higher. We had that confidence up. But you see how it's a steady growth? It's with this direction. You can't do that shit in normal casinos, yo. So it takes a while, but if you get the hang of it and you practice it, you get faster at it, but it still takes a while. It's that controlling in the meantime, controlling the brain, not to go too high with the stakes, get too confident, letting the ego take over. It's just, you know, focus. But you can make money from this. That's the thing. You can actually make, you can generally make money. Like, tell me any other way you can make money as fast as this. Like, if it was a big game, like, you literally could. I'm just fucking playing from the cruise. Is it? My turn is bursting, y'all. That's what smoking does for you. Don't smoke. Don't have these bad habits. Anyway, we're just, you know, fucking around right now. We're not even thinking. Sometimes you can use your gut instinct to play against this kind of shit, but more time you want to think. So, what, has it not played for a while? It hasn't played scissors. So we can try and go against the scissors, right? So scissors is that one there. We're gonna go and hit it with the rock. But I would literally say 4.48. That's my confidence. Assign your confidence levels with the bet amount. Bet sizing. See? Went for the win for this. And it hasn't played paper throw. It's played one paper in the past five. So we're going to go with paper. What? It's going to go with paper. We'll play with this. Alright. Again, not too high. Not too high with the stake. Because more time. Okay, so we're going to take a paper for a minute. So we're going to go again. And I'm hoping it's in the paper again, because then I can increase the stake. I hope it's a split. Them splits. Okay, it was an L. So it was lucky we didn't. I'm going to start this video at 100 because it takes a while. It does take a minute. But one day we're going to show you a nice, clean, you know, speeded up video or something. Anyway. Why has it not played for a while? It played paper. I knew it was going to play paper. We should have checked stuff for the high stakes. So it hasn't played rock, like, whatever. Paper. Paper at 2.2 confidence. That's literally nothing. But we could have lost that if we had, if we went too high with it. So let's just go up one. Fuck it. Fuck it, fuck it, fuck it. We got plenty of runway. When I say runway, I mean how many times can you lose with your current stake? So it's a 4. If we increase it to 8, that means we've got like 10 more times before we can, you know, so whatever. That's fun. Come on, I haven't played rock for a while. So yeah, we got that. We got that. 17, not too bad. Same as before. We should have increased it a little bit. Paper hasn't played paper for a while. So we're going to go with the scissors. 17, that was stupid. That was so fucking stupid. That was so fucking stupid. Oh! Boom! Headshot! Boom! Alright, so we're gonna keep going until we get that hundo. And then we're just gonna cut that video short. What is great is if you have a bigger bankroll than the bankroll of the house, because then you're literally like, it's so easy to win. It's so easy to win. You can literally, you know, whatever. That's why you gotta have a big bankroll if you're creating a game. Or you can kind of do this.